हेलो ऑल, वेलकम टू लेक्चर्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंस्टॉलेशन मेंटेनेंस एंड टेस्टिंग। वी आर डिस्कसिंग यूनिट 3, व्हिच इज मेंटेनेंस एंड कंडीशन मॉनिटरिंग। एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड विथ इंसुलेशन, पर्टिकुलरली इंसुलेशन टेस्टिंग, दैट इज पोलराइजेशन इंडेक्स एंड डाईइलेक्ट्रिक एब्सॉर्प्शन रेशियो। These are the learning outcomes for this video. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to retrieve some concepts, basic concepts of insulation testing. You will understand PI and DAR testing, that is polarization index and dielectric absorption ratio testing. And you can interpret the test results after testing. So after testing of insulation, particularly for PI and DAR, what should be the criteria to analyze the insulation? So that can be concluded after this lecture. So let's revise something related with insulation testing. Insulation testing is not that complex. Means the very basic law which we have learnt in basic electrical engineering, which is Ohm's law, is simply used for insulation testing. How I can explain you? So your Ohm's law is simply V is equal to IR. Now let us have some concepts related with resistance. So there are two types of resistances which are available in electrical circuits. One is resistance of actual conductor through which the current is flowing, and another is resistance of insulation which is present on the conductor. So two basic formulae you are aware of. So another formula you have learnt related with specific resistance and actual resistance. Now this, how this is used for measurement of insulation resistance: if you apply voltage across equipment insulation, and if you can measure amount of current flowing through that insulation, you can simply conclude about insulation resistance. So that is very simple thing. Now two concepts which are very basics, where you can confuse yourself, or you may confuse yourself, that I will just revise. The first concept is, please understand, for actual conductor resistance you require a minimum resistance for a conductor. Why? Because your losses are I square R losses. So criteria for conductor resistance is minimum. This R is directly proportional to L by A. So this conductor resistance is directly proportional to length. You increase the amount of length of the conductor, your resistance will increase. But at the other end, your insulation resistance IR is inversely proportional to the length. So there is a separate derivation you must have done in basic electrical engineering. So please understand the difference. This is your conductor resistance you can calculate. So conductor resistance is directly proportional to the length. Insulation resistance is inversely proportional to the length. Let's go back to our presentation. Yeah. So you must have understood the very basic thing which is used for insulation resistance testing is Ohm's law. Now if you compare your electrical current with the amount of water flow in any pipeline, you can definitely compare the type of insulation you are having, and what may be the issue with that insulation. So let's again, simply with the help of simple presentation, I would like to show you. Imagine this is your pipeline and the amount of water flowing through this pipeline. What will happen? There are two quantities present in this pipeline. One is pressure, another is flow. So this pipeline is always having its own capacity to contain the amount of water. Imagine if you increase the amount of water beyond sustainability of this pipeline. What will happen? Pressure increases, and somewhere to that pipeline there will be puncture through which water will burst out. So it's simply leakage of pipeline we are calling. In a similar way, or any kind of cable or any kind of equipment where there is presence of conductor and insulation above it, there is sustainability of that particular insulation. It's having ratings, and depending upon the pressure which you are applying across that insulation, if that goes beyond the limits, there will be some issue in terms of leakage current. So the bursting of pipeline is equivalent to leakage current over here. There are different reasons of insulation failure. So these are nothing but various stresses. First one is typically electrical stress. Right now we discussed there is always a limit beyond which you cannot apply voltage to particular insulation. So if you apply voltage which is crossing the limits for any insulation, there will be electrical stresses created, which will ultimately impact in insulation failure. There might be some mechanical stresses depending upon how you are handling that particular equipment. So imagine an underground cable where n number of vehicles are traveling on the road, and below cable is over there, so cable is under mechanical stresses. Chemical, yes, various gases or fumes, or imagine an area where area like mining industry where a lot of chemical activities are going on, oil and gas industry where a lot of chemical activities are going on, so that poisonous gases are being created, so they may impact the insulation. So that is another stress insulation is having. Thermal stresses, it's a direct heating stresses where some heating activities are going on, kind of electrical furnaces you are having, the cables which are installed in the vicinity of furnaces, there is creation of heat which is directly going to impact your insulation. And environmental resistance. So environmental resistance again comes, there comes a dust, then you may be having some presence of rodents like rats in the vicinity, and they may damage the insulation. So these are different types of stresses insulation may face. And how to test insulation resistance? This is again, I'll revise. The equipment principle for insulation resistance, that we are calling that as an insulation tester. It simply applies voltage across your insulation. It measures the amount of current flowing through that insulation. And simply by applying Ohm's law, V by I, it's calculating your resistance. Let's go ahead. Now, when you are doing some insulation resistance testing, what may be the different factors affecting this insulation resistance reading? First, two factors are always temperature and humidity, we can understand. We have just discussed different stresses where there were some different environmental stresses we were discussing. So these are typically environmental factor. So depending upon amount of temperature or humidity present in the environment, your insulation resistance value will change. So that is the these are the two main factors which are affecting insulation resistance reading. But let us keep these factors a bit aside, and we'll focus on what's the nature of current flowing through the insulation. So till date you might have simply understood current, but yes, there are three different types of currents which may be present whenever the actual current flows in the circuit. Now, first current is capacitance charging current. So take an example of equipment like cable. So cable is having conductor and insulation above it, and there is presence of cable capacitance. So this capacitance charging current is what? It's a charging, it's used for charging the capacitance between insulation system under test and earth. So this will draw a high current in the first instance before dropping off quickly to zero as the capacitor is charged. So its process is like, you know, charging of capacitances. Initially it is very high, then it will saturate like this. Another type of current, which is called as absorption current, is having a relationship with dipoles of dielectric medium. So I'll not go into the details of this dipole and what is dielectric medium and all. You can definitely refer your curriculum related with material science. So this is typically a discussion of material science. So alignment of the dipoles with the dielectric, with the applied electrical field, and for which this current is existing. And this current draws a high current initially, but then gradually drops off as the dipoles in the dipole become increasingly polarized. So polarization increases, your absorption current decreases. So ultimately, in the order of 5 to 10 minutes, your absorption current saturates. And last current, which is actually a leakage current, about which we were discussing, it's a conduction current through insulation. So that is called as leakage current. It's a leakage, like a leakage to pipeline. So our focus in this particular video is on this conduction or leakage current. Once you understood this, there are different types of insulation resistance testing depending upon how much time you are taking for insulation resistance testing. So very simple test, which is a short time test, which we call generally as at field taking a meager. But here I would like to explain, meager is actually a misnomer. Meager is the first company to design this insulation resistance tester. So equipment name is insulation resistance tester. Meager is name of the company. So short time testing, operation of insulation tester for a specific time period. And yes, in every test we are going to consider time, but this is typically for a kind of a 60 second. You are applying a voltage across insulation, you are measuring the current, and the equipment is giving you a reading. So this is sufficient test for small capacitance equipment. And thumb rule is 1 mega ohm for each 1000 volts for operating voltage with minimum value of 1 mega ohm. So insulation resistance value when you are taking a mega cannot go below 1 mega ohm. So minimum value requirement is 1 mega ohm. Otherwise, you have to look into the condition of the equipment, which you may not use in operation, like a cable. If its insulation resistance comes below 1 mega ohm, it is risky to use that cable for electrical operations. Now this is the thumb rule. Like if you are having an 11 kV equipment, here what will happen? 11 mega ohm must be the criteria. So it's a thumb rule. This is related regarding this short time test, but there are some other tests also which are called as a time resistance tests, which are fairly independent of temperature, independent of size of equipment also, and they establish some standard for insulation resistance. For example, if you take two different motors of different sizes, this time resistance testing will give you what should be the condition for insulation in any other motor. So they are kind of calibrating the amount of insulation resistance value. And because you are doing these tests for some higher time, or you are taking some ratios in these tests, they will give you clarity about insulation condition. So what are those tests? We'll see. Very simple thing. First is called as a dielectric absorption ratio. What you are doing here simply is you are taking insulation resistance only, but you are taking insulation resistance for 1 minute, you are taking insulation resistance for 30 seconds, and you are taking the ratio of those insulation resistances. So that DAR is nothing but equal to ratio of insulation resistance for 60 seconds divided by 30 seconds. So this is DAR. Some equipment nowadays are giving direct value of DAR on its digital screen. So very simple test. So what is the interpretation? So these are the ranges given by some IEEE standard. So DAR value 0 to 1 dangerous, DR is coming low, very dangerous. 1 to 1.3, poor. Above 1.3, you can start considering that insulation as a good one. 1.6 is excellent value. So, this is related with dielectric absorption ratio. Next one is polarization index. Similarly, similar to your DAR, you are going to take ratio, but R600, that is, you are going to take insulation resistance reading for 600 seconds, that is 10 minutes, to insulation resistance testing for 60 seconds. So, there for DAR it was R60 by R30, here it's R600 by R60. So, this test is primarily conducted on form wound motors and generators. So, interpretation is 0 to 1 range, it's dangerous, 1 to 2 poor, 2 to 5 it's good, and greater than 5 it's excellent. This greater than 5 value you may find in some literature greater than 4. So, greater than 4, greater than 5, you can start thinking of insulation as a excellent insulation. So, for more understanding, I have included here two links of videos which are available on YouTube. How to test or what are the in-depth, what is the in-depth assessment of polarization index, what are the methodologies to measure, and in another video I have included testing with the help of Fluke meter. Fluke is a very famous company for electrical measuring equipment. So you can, I suggest you can go through these two videos, and last one, you can come on my Padlet for discussion of the concepts which you have not understood throughout this video lecture, or to discuss some concepts related with insulation resistance testing. Please ensure you are mentioning your opinion or your understanding or your queries in the column maintenance and condition monitoring. I recommend a book which you may call a Bible of electrical condition monitoring and testing. It's a Paul Gill, very famous book, Electrical Power Equipment Maintenance and Testing. And there is one standard associated with it, IEEE standard, IEEE standard 43, current revision is 2013. So, I suggest you to go through this material, Paul Gill reference book, as well as IEEE standard 43 for more in-depth understanding of these two concepts, PI and DAR. Thank you. See you in the next lecture.